Hello, this is Rug Lover Mary, and today I have something very, well, it's exciting for me, not so exciting for the rug owner. If you see if I can steady the camera enough, you can see that casing is just slightly moving because it still has a larvae in it, and he's eating the rug. And literally, he is not that big. Compare it to my fingernail, which is less than a half of an inch wide. And this rug is covered in casings. You can see a whole bunch right in there. Oh, that one just moved. Cool. So it's really hard to see the larvae. Oh, because as soon as you touch the casing, he goes back in. I think I just missed him again. So I'm just gonna leave the camera. Well, you can see him coming out and then moving. There he goes, he's out and then he's in. Moving along to find a good spot on the rug to eat. This rug was being used. And then it got flood damage, and then it got rolled up and put aside while everything else was being dealt with. And then she decided, hey, I want to use that rug again. And as soon as I unrolled it, I started seeing casings, and I got excited about it. And then I've never seen them inside the casing still eating. He hasn't become an adult yet, but the longer that the rug doesn't move, the more that the casings with the live moth larvae in them move. They're all over the place, just wiggling. It's very rare that we find live larvae on a rug. And they're just going to town. You can see them all moving all around. It's kind of neat from a rug cleaning point of view and for a teaching point of view. All kinds of little flat pieces of rice looking, moving around, eating. This wool rug is hand tufted, so it's not a valuable rug. And she thought about getting it cleaned, moth treated, and then doing our flood treatment on it. But honestly, because it's a hand tufted rug, it's not really worth it. But if it was more valuable, then yes, it would be. Because there's not many fibers missing, but oh, he's definitely coming out now. There he is, chewing away. This type of moth is called the close moth, whereas the webbing moth leaves almost a slime looking trail after it as it moves around on the rug. I'm just gonna keep taping while they keep moving around. Because as soon as I touch them, they disappear. This is the highest area of concentration on this rug, but the casings are all the way through it. And as you can see, some of the ones over there are just slightly moving too. This guy by the leaf is very active. So that's why it's important And you do have the casings on the rug to get it moth treated, not just cleaned, so that you're also getting all the eggs. And from what we are seeing, the larvae are in the casings right now. So when you move the rug, they all stay still and look dead. But it doesn't mean that they are, obviously. Because they're in the casing, eating the rug, and moving around all at the same time. To catch them on film when they're popping out of the casing because they're eating the wool fiber and digging down into it to get to the really good stuff. This has been Rug Lover Mary. I'll show you the back to prove that it is a hand tufted rug with the fabric on the back. 100% wool pile, made in India, with very alive moth larvae.